Hi, Universal Music Canada. This is Mother Mother here, and we're here to get exposed.
Now take off your pants. Sorry.
You take off your pants.
I would love to. Question from Daniel Mercurio.
Yes.
Mercurio?
Mercurio.
Like Mercury?
Exactly, like Freddie Mercury, but
right.
Mercurio.
Like the planet. It goes something like this. Do each of you have a favorite song to perform live? I'm tending to like the ones that are easier to play live these days. Not because I'm lazy, just because it allows you to kind of get into it and not worry about all like the little nuances and stuff. So a song like I Go Hungry, I really like, because it just kind of, it's like just driving, kind of cruising. It just does itself. And I like Reaper Man, because it's kind of similar. It's just, it just sort of plods along and you just sort of hop on for the ride. And there's that cool riff. I like playing riffs quite a lot.
I like that riff too. It's Reaper Man for me on the new record, and it's Sleep Awake is my favorite Mother Mother song to play of all time.
Really?
Yeah.
That's odd.
You know what? There's just something so dynamic and beautiful about it that
you just like doubling my backup vocals.
Yeah.
That's why. Because we never get to do it. We never get to double backup vocals.
True.
It's usually Molly and Jasmine that are doubling all the backup vocals.
I really like the thing too.
You have to do it with the hand.
That was totally not the melody at all, but that's the thing I like to do. This is from Kaylee D Music. Which song was your favorite to record, and which took the longest?
I think my favorite to record. There's facets to making music, and you know, some of them are instrumental, some of them are kind of computer driven, some of them are, you know, just watching the drums being made, some of it's about the emotional outlet of singing. So yeah, they're all very different, so it's kind of hard to like put it into one, but I think I'm gonna go for the latter, the emotional singing quality. Have It Out, that song was quite an experience to perform in the studio. It was just one take. My voice was kind of spent, and which definitely enhanced, I think, the performance, because it's kind of a very broken song with a broken meaning, and the performance was broken as well. And yeah, it just kind of felt special and authentic, to use a word that is used all too often these days. I have it out with myself, with myself. I have it out. And Monkey Tree took the longest.
My favorite to record on this album was actually Get Out the Way, because it was just so much fun. It was originally this crazy prog metal song. We ended up kind of sort of truncating it, making it a little bit different, but in the initial stages there was a lot of other stuff that happened, and one time being a massive ridiculous scream done by yours truly, and it was very funny and fun and just a good time all around.
It was actually remarkable, like the scream that you produced was remarkable. It just climbed to this stratospheric places. It's pretty wild. Quite the vocal feat.
We do have it, so.
And why didn't we use it?
We should expose it.
It wasn't commercially viable.
My screams are not commercially viable, so.
From Doug Wright, with a W. Doug Wright. Do you have a bucket list? Name one thing still on it. You ever seen Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas? You know, it's similar to that. I'd like to just throw a dart at a map and then go to the airport with a pile of cash and go to that place and then just keep doing that for like 5 years, mm-hmm. with just no direction, no plan, mm-hmm. just complete whimsy and spontaneity, and seeing the world, that kind of thing. I would like to do that.
Mm. I would like to go to where yoga began in India. I think it's Rikishesh. I think that's the birthplace of yoga. But I'm a total hippie. No, I'd like to go there, just live there for a few months, just study and hang out and soak up the culture.
Go to a couple full moon parties.
Go to a couple full moon parties, yeah. It's not a very, really exciting bucket list thing, like Fear and Loathing.
It's not exciting, it's stupid. Mine's stupid, yours is deep and rich and soulful. You're good to go.
That's because I'm a deep, rich, and soulful human being.
I know.
And you are lacking in all those departments.
That's why you're in the band.
This is from Stumpologist.
At Stumpologist. If you care to follow at Stumpologist.
Which lyric do you think is the most powerful / is your favorite on the album?
I like Slash, the guitar player from Guns N' Roses. He's my favorite lyric on the album. Oh, I'm sorry. You go first.
I have to think, so no, you first.
Okay. I'm just trying to put off my answer. It's probably not appropriate in any respect. It contains a swear word. But it's from the song Have It Out. I think I just have a thing with that song. I think that song is kind of like my jam. And the line where it goes, can't fuck the young ones. 'Cause I'm a con artist, can't kiss the girls. Fuck the young ones. That's my lyric. Not my lyric. That's the one that just kind of, I don't know, it's got a lot of weight. A lot of implication there. Because I think there's, you know, there's a lot of things wrong with the world. One of them is the great imbalances and inequalities and contradictions and hypocrisies of the genders, men and women, and sexual viability and expiration unfairly bestowed on some and not others. And that's that line and that lyric brings up all that stuff in me. Mm. And just makes me think about it. So whether or not it's a good thing, whether or not it's a positive thing, it's just definitely the most effective lyric.
Mm, that was nice.
You're nice.
Thank you. My favorite lyric, I think, is in Kept Down. Right now, I can't remember all the lyrics, but the one that I'm trying to get at is...
You can't remember all the lyrics right now? What's
no,
wrong?
No, I can't recall everything in this moment, but there's just some things a guy like that can't say out loud. You're talking about the dad.
Mm.
Really speaks to me because there's this incredible image of the dad who can't express his feelings to his children, and I think there's something very sad and very dark and also very beautiful about that. I just really like the way it rolls off the tongue when you say it. It's just some things a guy like that can't say out loud. It just really does something for me.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go.
One too. Killing it.
Okay, this is from @Julie_Y, or if you
Julie.
Want to... Julie.
Yeah.
What's been your favorite part of touring so far?
Go first.
My favorite part of touring is playing shows pretty much every day. That's my favorite part of touring, because touring is hard. It's hard on the physical, the mental, the emotional. It's very close quarters for long periods of time with many people. And that can also be hilarious and fun and funny, and it can also be very grating. But at the end of the day, I think whether you're a crew member or whether you're a band member, the reward is the show. And that is still the same for me.
Even if you're like a hubcap on the bus, I think.
They're like, sweet, it's showtime.
Payoff is big. Yeah, it's a tough one. Yeah, I like all the stuff, the playing and the obvious things for sure. Like, it's such a gift to do this. And the stage and that opportunity is amazing. But I think for me, at a moment, before we even played our first shows in Halifax, we arrived in Halifax, we had a rehearsal, and then we had a day to kind of chill before playing our first show. And I went for a walk by myself in Halifax. I think it was either Sunday or a national holiday. And so it was very dead and quiet. And kind of, I don't know, moody outside. Gray skies and Halifax is beautiful.
Crazy wind gusts.
Yeah, lots of wind gusts. And so it was just kind of like complex and tumultuous, the energy. And it was just a moment where I got to take all that in and just meditate on this tour that was about to happen. So it's going to be this big adventure, playing every night, and this moment of otherworldly calm and complexity where I got to just think about that and take a breath and go, here we go. Yeah, so the walk in Halifax.
Thanks for submitting your questions.
No, it really is crazy, the fact that anybody would want to know about us. It's humbling. Thank you.
For reals.
No, for reals, yeah. Wasn't being sarcastic.
It's hard to tell with them sometimes, but we really are for real. Thank you so much, and let's chat again soon.